In this video presentation, we're going to look at the switch fuse connection unit, often called on site a switch fuse spur. And we're going to look at it from the point of view of the back of the electrical accessory, and we're going to be looking at identifying the final circuit terminations as well as the load terminations. Now, these change between manufacturer. I've got three different manufacturers here, and we will see in this video presentation how the position of the terminals in the back of the accessory and the labeling of them differ between each of the manufacturers. So a switch fuse connection unit allows us to take a final circuit and fuse it down appropriately to the load that we're feeding. The section here on this one is the position of which the fuse is inserted, and they are BS1362 fuses, ones we've seen previously for plug tops, remembering the three common sizes of 13, 5 and 3 amps. All of them come fitted with a 13 amp BS1362 fuse, and in the workshop it's our responsibility to change that fuse appropriate to the load in which we're feeding. The fuse connection unit here incorporates a switch. This is a double pole switch and can be used for isolation. We often see these out in industry, feeding things such as electric hand dryers, and in domestic dwellings, perhaps in kitchens, feeding things such as washing machines, dishwashers and fridge freezers, maybe even identified with writing on them in order that we know that that switch fuse spur or switch fuse connection unit is actually the isolating point, say for an extractor fan. So let's bring the camera in and look at the positions and the labeling of the terminations on the back of these three switch fuse connection units next. So this is the first of the three switch fuse connection units we're going to look at the back of, and this is possibly the most simplistic of the three. One side we can clearly see the word supply, the symbol for earth, an N for neutral and an L for line. On the second side, we can see the word load. We can see an N for neutral, an L for line, and the symbol for earth. So let's look at the side, first of all, labeled supply. This is our final circuit wiring. It may be that we've wired our circuits in PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables, sometimes called twin and earth cables. It may be that we've wired our circuit in PVC singles. So it's the circuit from our consumer unit that goes round to our electrical accessories. It's the supply side. We can see the symbol for earth, where our CPC will be connected. We've got the N, where our neutral conductor or conductors will be connected, and the L, where our line conductor or conductors will be connected. So let's have a look at the load side of this switch fuse connection unit. So we've got our terminations, neutral, line, and where our CPC will be connected. And this will be the item of which we're installing, such as the hand dryer. It could be that we're using fixed wiring. So again, that cable may be still buried in the fabric of the building or incorporated in another enclosure. Or it could be that we're using the cord grip section at the bottom and we're coming out with a flex or flexible cable in order to connect to our load. It's now important that we look at the load and match the fuse installed within the fuse connection unit to match that. Remembering they always come with a 13 amp fuse, and often this will need to be changed maybe to a 5 or a 3 amp fuse depending on the load. So let's have a look at our second fuse connection unit next. So this is the back of the second switch fuse connection unit, and already you can see the layout is completely different. We have one word that we recognize from before, which is load. We have a new word introduced, which is the word in. We still have N and L to represent neutral and line conductors. And on the right hand side, we have two brass terminals and the earth symbol where our CPCs will be connected. So we're now looking for our fixed wiring terminals. We've got at the top an L identified above it with in, and at the bottom an N identified with the word in as well. This is the circuit wiring. This is the wiring from the consumer unit that we've installed to feed this electrical accessory. The CPCs from our final circuit can go in either of the brass terminals identified with the earth symbol. It wouldn't matter which one we chose of the two in order to install our final circuit CPC. The item we are feeding from this switch fuse connection unit, again the example being that electric hand dryer, will come out of the terminals labeled with the word load. So as we look at this, we can see an N with the word above it saying load. That would be the outgoing neutral. And on the other side, we can see the word load with an L being the outgoing line conductor. Remember, this could be in fixed wiring, or again, it could be in a flexible cable. And you can see at the bottom there, we've got another cord grip to support that flexible cable if it went out, say, to the electric hand dryer. And again, it wouldn't matter which one of the two brass terminals identified with the earth symbol we use for the load CPC. Again, before finishing off this electrical accessory, please ensure the fuse on the front plate has been appropriately selected to match the load. So we can see on the back of our third switch fuse connection unit, we have yet another layout for our terminals. However, we do have words now that we recognise. We have the word in and the word out. So our final circuit wiring will be our in terminations. So we can see there L in for our final circuit wiring and N in for our final circuit wiring being our line and neutral terminations. We can also see that we've got two brass earth terminals, one on each side, of which our final circuit CPC can be connected. And again, it wouldn't matter which one of the two you choose to connect your CPC into. Hopefully now it's quite obvious which terminals we're going to use, say for that electric hand dryer, our load element of the actual circuit itself. So we can clearly see there an L marked with the word out, that would be our line outgoing, and N out is our neutral outgoing to say that electric hand dryer. Again, it wouldn't matter which of the two brass terminals we chose to connect our CPC into. And again, we've got the ability, if we wanted to use a flexible cable in order to feed our load, we've also got a cord grip as well. So that was a little look at three manufacturers, and we can see clearly how the termination positions and the labeling of those terminations differs between each of the electrical accessories. I hope this video has been some help.